One of the most memorable moments in the first Jurassic Park movie is when Alan Grant, the paleontologist, is first seeing dinosaurs in the flesh, and he's kind of gasping when he sees them and says they're moving in herds. How do we know, and how can we extrapolate behavior from something from the fossil record? That is not intuitive at all.
See, one of the things that happens is when we think about the sort of the imagery of paleontology on television in the movies, it's often that lone person, you know, cleaning up that one skeleton in the field. First of all, we mostly clean them up in the lab because it's easier and safer. But that being said, birds are related to dinosaurs, and we know that birds flock. Well, it means that you can't necessarily find a flock in the fossil record, but occasionally you do. And to give credit where credit's due, one of the people who was fundamental in this was Jack Horner. And a lot of people like to say that Grant was based on Jack in some ways. But Jack has got some localities, and others have since as well, where we find many, many, many animals together in one place. And not only many animals, but animals of multiple generations, adults, juveniles, and babies, which means there must have been a social component and possibly even parental care. And so we know that they must have lived in groups at some point. Now, seeing them move in groups is not too long a stretch.